Although the structure of the iPad is surprisingly rugged, the entire face of it is made of glass. And like anything made of glass, it's breakable. Hi, I'm MJ with iFixit, and today I'm going to show you how to replace the front panel assembly on the original iPad. While I'm doing that, I'll give you some helpful tips on the trickier parts, but really your best resource is the step-by-step repair guide on our site. You don't have to pause it, and you don't have to rewind it, and you can print it out and write on it if you need to. So make sure to pull that up and give it a once-over before you get started. Along with instructions, you're going to need some tools, and it's best to get those together before you get started. For this repair, you're going to need two metal spudgers, a set of plastic opening tools, a T5 Torx screwdriver, and your replacement front panel. Rather than getting just the one driver, I'd opt for something like our 26-piece bit driver kit, because it has most of the bits you'll ever need, and it's small enough to fit in your pocket. You can find the bit driver kit and the rest of the tools at iFixit.com. Now that I've got my parts and tools together, I can get started. I'm going to use one of my metal spudgers at the top of the iPad. I'm going to insert it in between the front panel and the rear of the iPad. Once it's in there, I'm just going to rotate it away and lift the front panel off. Once all the locking clips are released along the top, you're going to take the spudger and insert it in between the front panel and the rear case, and just leave it there. That way, when we're working around the right side of the iPad, the locking clips don't lock back into place. So you're pretty much going to do the same thing around the other three sides of the iPad. And once all the locking clips are released, we can start to lift the display assembly off the iPad. Once all the locking tabs have been released, I'm going to start to lift the front panel off down by the bottom of the iPad. And I'm not going to lift it all the way off because it's still connected via some ribbon cables underneath. And you can kind of see those. I'm going to use my fingers and a plastic opening tool to disconnect those. That way we can move on. Now that all the ribbon cables are disconnected, we can put the rear part of the iPad aside and begin separating the LCD from the front panel. The first thing we're going to remove is this ambient light sensor that's held down by some adhesive. I'm going to use one of my plastic opening tools to kind of go around the edge of it and loosen it up. And once it's loosened, we should be able to pull it right off. Now that I've got the ambient light sensor removed, there are a few T5 Torx screws that are securing the LCD to the frame. I'm going to have to take those out before I can move on. The LCD is attached with adhesive, so I'm going to use one of my plastic opening tools and, starting near the top of the iPad, gently pry the LCD away from the frame. The LCD is made of glass, so you want to be careful not to break the LCD, especially if you intend on reusing it. Once the top is free, you're going to do the same thing all the way around the iPad until you get to the edge that's secured with tape. Once you've got those three sides free, you're going to lift the LCD from one of its corners, gently taking that tape with you, like that. Now that the LCD is off, we're going to remove the home button switchboard, which is held in place by two more T5 Torx screws. Okay. The very last thing to look out for is to check and see if this piece of EMI tape is actually attached to your front panel. If it is, you're going to want to remove it from the old front panel and transfer it to the new front panel. After that, all you've got to do is reassemble your iPad. Just make sure that both the LCD and the new front panel are totally clean. That way you don't put it back together and see that you've trapped a whole bunch of dust and fingerprints on the inside. You can find all of the parts and tools for this and many other repairs at iFixit.com. And if you run into any problems during your repairs, there are lots of solutions in the iPad repair guide on our site. Thanks for watching and happy repairing.